Hi everybody and welcome to a very cold day here in the rescue zoo. Today we are gonna follow Lasse, one of our keepers here in the rescue zoo, as he is gonna feed the raccoons. And he is gonna tell us a bit about what it means to feed the raccoons, especially here in the winter time, what we need to look after, what he does to make sure they can keep warm and happy and healthy.
So today's video is actually the Danish video I made for Danish Facebook.
And as I did last time, I have done an English voiceover to make sure that the international audience can still understand the Danish parts. And yeah, let's just get started with today's video.
Ja, men vi har lige været ned og fodret vaskebjørnene, og de får også frugt og grøntsager. Og det er lidt mere sådan, forskellige former for grøntsager, de får også. Og det samme med frugten, lige i den her tid her, får de masser af banan, fordi der er lidt mere fedme i bananerne. Og det er egentlig bare for, at vi kan sørge for, at de ikke taber sig her på grund af kulden.
So Lasse starts out by telling us that he gives them a variety of fruits and greens, and especially banana here in these cold, cold times is very important because there's lots of fats in them, and you know, they need to keep warm throughout the winter, so it's very, very important that we can keep up their body weight, and that is one of the ways they do it, through the diet.
Så vi på den måde kan sørge for, at de bliver ved med at have en god temperatur, så de ikke går og fryser.
So he says, so we can make sure they keep up a good body warmth. One of the ways is to make sure they don't lose weight, especially here in the winter time.
Og så får de også forskellige former fra protein. Det kan være lidt forskelligt kød, lidt melorme og daggamle kyllinger og æg. Og så får de hundepiller også igen, fordi de her hundepiller indeholder vitaminer, mineraler og flere proteiner. Og proteinerne er bare sund for dem, fordi de er det der hedder en omnivore, så de spiser i princippet alt. Så det er både kød og grøntsager, de spiser.
Here Lasse is telling us that proteins are also extremely important for them. We give them eggs and chicken and mealworms, and we also give them dog food because there's lots of minerals and vitamins and proteins in this, and which is especially important again here in winter time. So Les is also telling us that the raccoons are omnivore, and that means it's an animal that has the ability to eat and survive on both plants and animal matter, and that way we need to make sure they get both fruits, greens and proteins, and basically they eat everything.
Ja, de har jo det her pels, som selvfølgelig holder sig varm, og den måde de sover på her i vores park her, det er at de har nogle træstammer, der er udhulet, hvor de kan lægge sig ned i, og så har de to af sådan nogle hylder, og dem fylder vi selvfølgelig med halm, som de kan ligge og varme sig rigtig godt i de her kolde perioder her, så der aldrig er nogen af dem, der fryser.
The raccoons have this very, very thick fur, and this will give them the ability to keep warm throughout the winter. One of the ways that we are also helping them to keep warm here through the winter is that we are giving them these big logs of wood that has been carved out, and then they can sleep inside of them. We then fill them up with hay to help them to really keep the warm throughout the winter. We've also built them three different shelves that is also been filled up with hay, and again, so they can sort of mix and match in where they want to sleep, and yeah, we're just giving them the options to keep warm throughout the winter.
Men generelt, en vaskebjørn er vel god til at holde varme?
Jo, den er jo ikke, den har en ret tyk pels, men det er jo selvfølgelig altid være koldt, og selvom at de fra naturens side er skabt til, at de er nogle af de steder, hvor de måske lever i naturen, at der er koldt der, så er det stadig bare dejligt at have noget varmt halm at putte sig i.
And I asked Lasse if the raccoons aren't just really, really good at keeping warm in general, and of course he says that they have this very, very thick fur from nature, so of course they are good in general to keep warm, but it's always nice to have a good and hot and nice bed to sleep in, and it's, of course we give the animals all their needs they need here in the rescue zoo.
Jamen, deres livret, det er kylling. Det er det bedste, de ved.
Så det, de går efter med
ja,
det samme?
Ja, præcis. Og nogle gange for at drille dem, så ligger jeg det her kylling i bunden af deres madskål. Og så vender de fuldstændig madskålene på hovedet for at få fat i det her kylling her. Og så spiser de det, og så spiser de deres hundepiller bagefter. Og så frugten. Og så allersidst, der spiser de grøntsagerne. Og det værste, de ved, det er bare sådan noget bladgrønt og salat. Det nægter de simpelthen at spise.
Så det er ligesom os andre?
Ja, lige præcis.
Lastly, I asked Lasse what are the favorite thing that the raccoons are eating, and he says chicken. And he even does this thing that sometimes he likes to hide it at the bottom of it to just trying to see if it really is their favorite thing and to see what they do. It's a bit of enrichment, you can say. And that just results in that the raccoons go strictly directly for the bottom of the of their food. And I basically just flips it over to to get the favorite thing. And the last thing they're gonna eat is the veggies. And some of the things like celeries and stuff, they simply are not gonna touch at all. Friends, we've reached the end of today's YouTube video. I hope you enjoyed. And we are very soon back with another one. Remember, if you want to see more of us, we are live on Twitch on Sundays, Tuesdays, and Fridays. Leaving a comment down below and telling your friends is a huge help to spreading the word of everything we do here at the Rescue Zoo. It was Niko here, and I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful evening, day, wherever you are watching this. Take care, guys. Niko and Alex in the Rescue Zoo.
And today we are...
I'm gonna tell the story about how I grew up in a rescue zoo.
Hi, I'm Niko, and welcome to the first zoo and rescue center for exotic animals in Denmark, and also my home.
20 years ago, my parents bought a zoo in Denmark and converted it into a rescue zoo instead. So that means we take in animals who had a hard life one way or another. It could be from the medical industry, cosmetic industry, or private people obtaining illegal exotic animals. You can see this as a retirement home for older animals who had a hard life one way or another. Unfortunately, we lost my dad to cancer here a few years ago. I was out on my own working as a game developer, but I quickly moved home again to the rescue zoo to help out my mother and the 600 animals living here. One of the ways that I'm helping out is that I'm live streaming our everyday life, and I'm developing a game called Rescue Wars Online, and 100% of the profit is going to help all the rescue animals.